Hey, I'm Becca with the Happy Ever Crafter, and this video is going to be a little different than most of my videos. I have decided to do a new little series here on YouTube, more about business and life stuff and the questions that people often ask me that aren't necessarily tutorial related. So at this point, I'm thinking that every second week on Fridays, I'm going to release a new video that's business related and answer some of those questions for people. So these are going to be a little more candid, a little less scripted, a little more off the cuff, and just me genuinely answering questions that you guys ask me all the time. It only makes sense to start with the beginning, and one of the questions that I get all the time from people is how I got started. So here's my story in a nutshell, and then at the end I'm going to give you my three tips if this is something that you're looking at exploring too. So I learned calligraphy in 2015. And I was working at a job that I actually really enjoyed at the time. I was working for a company here in Canada that is like, it's sort of like a smaller Canadian Walmart, essentially. And I was on the construction team for doing like the floor plans and all of that kind of stuff for the construction of new stores and renovating old ones. So I did a lot of floor plans and a lot of like creative work, but not in the normal sense of it. It was more like technical creative work. And so I really enjoyed that. It's what I went to school for. I studied interior design. And that I was not planning on leaving that job. I really liked the people I was working with. I loved all of it, but I felt like I needed like sort of a creative outlet. And so I found a woman here in Ottawa named Joanne. I think if you guys have stuck around here for a while, you know who Joanne is, because Joanne is the one who taught me calligraphy. So she taught calligraphy classes out of her home, and I happened upon her Instagram and I found it and I just got so excited, and I dragged a bunch of my friends with me to a workshop at her place one night. And I'm not even kidding, I did that 3-hour workshop. It was a point and pen workshop, and I went home and I was dreaming about it. I was like so excited, I was buzzing with this new hobby that I was obsessed with already after just 3 hours, and I'm sure a lot of you can relate to that. So I just kept practicing after that night, and I got really, really obsessed and just kept practicing and practicing pretty much every night after work. I would come home and I got one of those tables that was like cantilevered over the couch sort of, and like around my lap, and so I could sit and watch TV and just do calligraphy all night. And I was practicing for probably like 2 hours a day at that point. And I just picked it up really quickly. I really enjoyed it. Because of my school background, I was not ever a super great drawer or anything, but I was really good at handwriting. I always really liked handwriting. And anyway, I picked it up pretty quickly. I just kept going. And then I decided to start sharing my work on a new Instagram account, because I had been sharing it a little bit on my personal one, and my friends were kind of like, why are you showing us all this weird, like not very good calligraphy on your personal account? Nobody cares. They didn't say that, but that's what I assumed. So I started this new Instagram account called The Happy Ever Crafter. And at the time I thought that my skills could be transferred into maybe doing wedding seating charts or place cards or something like that. So it was kind of a play on words of like happy ever after, but crafter, because I was going to be doing crafts for weddings. So anyway, that's where I went with that, and I started my account, and I just kind of assumed that I would share things to crickets for a while, but it took off. I started sharing videos, like time lapses of me doing some writing, and people just really liked seeing it. And then over time, it just kept growing, and I had people asking me if I could share like what tools I was using or how I learned, or if I could actually teach them like a little mini tutorial. So I just started noticing these trends and questions that were coming up, and I was just genuinely starting to answer them for people. And then they started asking me to teach. And what happened was actually Joanne noticed my Instagram account and noticed that I was getting pretty good at calligraphy, and she asked me to start teaching with her. So we kind of came up with a plan, and we ended up hosting one workshop together where she taught most of it, and then she'd have me step in and teach a couple parts, and I just realized how much I really liked teaching. So at the end of that workshop, Joanne ended up saying to me, like, you don't need to do this for me, you should do this on your own, which is amazing of her, and I could go off on a long tangent about that. But anyway, yeah, so I started teaching workshops in person in Ottawa, and those were always getting sold out because people really want to learn calligraphy. And then my following online started asking me to teach online because obviously they couldn't come to Ottawa to take my workshops. So I was still working full-time at this point. I was posting on Instagram every day. Even that started getting a little bit overwhelming, like it was a lot to do both at the same time. And then when people started asking me to teach, I used my prior knowledge in Photoshop and Illustrator, and I was able to make a basic strokes workbook, which became Show Me Your Drills. And I decided to start a challenge on Instagram, having people learn the basics of calligraphy, because I noticed a lot of people were skipping the basics and just trying to write the alphabet. So I really wanted to bring awareness to that. And so it was just a free thing. And it obviously took off because that is like the center of my business now. Everything I do revolves pretty much around Show Me Your Drills. And if you don't know what that is, I'll link to it. But yeah, that's my main program. So that's how that started. And after I made the free workbook, people started asking me for the next steps. And I just kind of made things as people requested them. And I had an audience of people who were really, really into that. And if you're one of those people and you're watching this and you remember all of this unfolding, I love that you're still here. That's amazing. I know a lot of people are still here, which is like, just blows my mind. I'm so happy that it has worked out this way and that the community has grown so amazingly. But yeah, so I made the next workbook, which was the lowercase letters, and I put it on sale. It was just a digital download, as they all still are, and I actually took the day off work to be home that day to run the sale and make sure my website didn't crash. And long story short, the website did crash. I didn't know what I was doing. Nothing was set up properly. I was just kind of like flying by the seat of my pants and just trying to get this out for people no matter what I had to do. And it just did so well. Everybody wanted it. And I actually ended up making a lot more money on that than I thought I would. And it just, I remember just it, like that day, my life fully changed. So I, at that point I started realizing like maybe this was something that I should explore a little bit more. I was really loving teaching. I was still obviously really loving doing the calligraphy. And I was getting clients at the same time too. People who saw that I could teach it obviously knew that I could do it, and they started asking me to do it for weddings and all that kind of stuff. So it was turning into a business, and I realized that I couldn't sustain my full-time job and this business on the side anymore. I had been getting up at 5 a.m. to work before work, and then work on my lunch break, and then work on the business after my work, and it was just too much. So essentially I set a goal for myself to match my salary and kind of get my ducks in a row, and then I would leave my job, which was really terrifying, and I think that'll be the topic of another one of these videos someday. But I ended up leaving my job and started doing this full time, and I've been doing it full time ever since. So that's kind of my story, and I think that a lot of people can probably relate to that. If you are starting to do calligraphy and people are asking you to do it for work, maybe not even teaching it, maybe just doing it for clients, and you're starting to get a lot of clients and realizing that this might be something that you want to take full-time and that you really enjoy. I just have a couple pieces of advice. So three things that I learned, and looking back, I was trying to think like what I would tell myself if I was in those shoes now. And the first one is to do it as a side hustle for as long as you can. There are so many benefits to that. And actually there's a really, really great book by Sean Wess, and I'll link to it down below. But it's called Overlap, and it's all about how to have your day job paying the bills and covering your essential needs, and then doing your side hustle on the side for a while, so that you not only have enough money and you're not feeling the pressure of having this side hustle make all of your full-time living, but you're also discovering whether or not it's something that you would want to do as a full-time job. Because when you first learn a new skill, like let's say calligraphy, it's a hobby and you're passionate about it because there's no pressure on it. But things sort of change when you're making money off of it and it's for clients and people are relying on you and it's not necessarily something that you're just sitting down to enjoy. Now there's pressure. And so it just sort of changes the narrative a little bit when it goes full time. So side hustling is awesome because you don't have the pressure of needing the money, but you also don't have the pressure of like this needing to be something that's satisfying other people. It's just for you for a while, and you can really start to understand if this is something that you would be willing to put on the line or if you want to just keep it for yourself. It doesn't have to ever make you money. It can just be something that you enjoy. So that's my first tip. My second one is to share your progress early and share your progress even if you don't really know what you're doing at the beginning. So if you scroll back all the way on my Instagram, you'll find some pretty old pictures and videos that are not very good. And that's how I started. I wasn't trying to impress anybody right off the bat. I was trying to just hold myself accountable and share my work. And I was actually also thinking like, in the future, I'm gonna be happy when I come back and look at this. And I am. Now when I go back and look at it, I'm like really proud of how far I've come. So don't stop yourself from posting your work just because you're not perfect yet. You're always gonna feel like your work could be better before you post it. But if you do that, then you'll never do it. And you'll never start it and the ball won't start rolling. So it's just a matter of gaining that momentum and you have to start somewhere. So start posting your progress even if it's not perfect. The third one is to practice as much as you can and learn as much as you can and just sort of become a sponge in the industry. So follow lots of people that are doing similar things, follow lots of people that are doing different things, read the blogs, listen to the podcasts, watch the YouTube videos, take in as much as you can and really just start to absorb it. So when I was still side hustling, I was listening to podcasts on my way into work, I was watching YouTube tutorials at lunch or even just listening to them while I worked. I had that benefit while I was there, but all different ways to just take in as much information as you can and really just start to understand new concepts and new things, and they'll start to kind of translate into your work. So those are my three top tips, but my like main overarching theme is always going to be to just start before you're ready. And my favorite quote is, done is better than perfect. So start posting your work, start doing more. Even if it's not going to be perfect, it's gradually going to get better and better and better. And if you wait till it's perfect, it's never gonna be. Just like this video series that I'm filming right now, this is definitely gonna get better, but I had to start somewhere. So hopefully this all makes sense. Hopefully you enjoyed hearing a little bit about my story and maybe you learned a thing or two about how I got to where I am. And I look forward to telling you more of my business tips and how I grew this thing. So if you have any comments or questions for a next video or just in general, definitely leave them down in the comments below. I try and read and respond to as many as I can. And again, this is gonna become a series, so make sure you're subscribed to the channel and you'll get notified whenever I put new videos out. And I'll see you next time.